So in a few of my videos, I talk about the relationship between potassium and blood pressure. But I had someone recently ask, why does potassium help lower blood pressure? And that's what this video is about. Just some quick background information. Only 2% of the population, and I'm talking about Americans, get enough potassium. 2%. That means 98% of Americans are deficient. They're just not getting enough. Most of them don't know that they need a lot. They need about 4,700 milligrams a day to achieve the RDAs for potassium. And I'm not talking about bananas, because bananas only have about 300 milligrams. So you'd have to consume a lot of bananas to achieve this. And then the problem with that is all the sugar that comes along with it. But mostly you're going to get your potassium from leafy greens, certain vegetables. The problem with that is an average American only consumes 1.5 cups of veggies per day, when they actually need about 7 to 10 cups. But realize, when I'm talking about 7 to 10 cups, I'm talking about like loose lettuce. I'm not talking about concentrated like broccoli, for example, or cauliflower. This would be for leafy greens. So if you're going to do something more dense, maybe you do four cups, something like that. And also, if you chop this up and cut this down, this is going to come down a lot less, because you're actually making it more dense. But the point is that the more vegetables that you eat, the closer you're going to get to this amount. You can also get potassium from fish and some meats and nuts, and definitely avocados. That's a really good source. Most people just don't get enough potassium from their diet. Also, when you consume refined carbohydrates, both in grain carbohydrates and sugars, you'll deplete your potassium even more. When you're under stress, you deplete your potassium. When you take a diuretic, you deplete your potassium. There's many different ways that people end up being deficient in potassium. If we take a look at sodium, the opposing mineral, 90% of Americans are consuming too much of sodium. So we're really heavy on the sodium, but very light on the potassium. And what this creates is a situation where your blood pressure is going to start going higher and higher and higher. Potassium in general has a diuretic effect. It's going to get rid of fluid. Potassium causes the smooth muscle in your arteries to dilate. It's a vasodilator, thus lowering the blood pressure. Also, potassium keeps the vascular system from being stiff, because if your arteries are stiff, that alone can cause hypertension. Either increase the foods that are high in potassium, which I'll put some links down below on that, or take potassium as a supplement or an electrolyte powder, and you're going to find that your blood pressure is going to start coming down. Now, the other cause of hypertension is low vitamin D3. So if you take vitamin D3 and potassium, or get it from the food, you will find that your blood pressure should be coming down. The other thing I'm going to mention about potassium is it also lowers the risk of getting a stroke. And the way that that occurs is that potassium directly affects the consistency of blood. It reduces clotting, as in blood clots. Potassium can kill two birds with one stone. Of course, that's not the best analogy, but it can actually help reduce hypertension and decrease the risk for a stroke.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple.
We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.